Hey, what's up, guys? Prestige here. I hope you are all having a great day. Today is December 11th, and that means that if you are on the Xbox 360 or Xbox One version of Call of Duty Advanced Warfare and you have the Season Pass, you are now able to use the AE4 and the AE4 Widowmaker variation. And that's exactly what we're going to be using in today's gameplay. I wanted to actually give you guys an idea of what this weapon is like, what attachments I found the most useful, and everything of the sort. This is a really interesting weapon, and I decided to put on the royalty camouflage as well because I know a lot of you are interested in seeing what the camouflage display looks like. We're using the Widowmaker in this gameplay, and actually what that does is it provides a blue laser instead of a red laser. You have an accuracy increase, but a decreased fire rate, and overall, it's an interesting awesome directed energy weapon, and with that directed energy, that means you will never run out of ammunition. The only thing you'll have to worry about is overheating, but that's also a benefit to this weapon. First off, let's just talk about the benefits of this weapon. Infinite ammo, there's one. The second thing is, even when overheating, that's still a benefit because it only takes about 1.5 seconds to throw the battery out of your weapon and throw a new one in there. It's actually really fast. It does have a slow rate of fire. The damage is not too good with it, and you will find yourself being beat out more of the times when going head-on with somebody, but that's all, again, you know, some of the downsides to some awesome benefits that you have. Now, there are a few attachments that I can definitely recommend. In this particular gameplay, I'm using three of them, which would be the foregrip, the quick draw handle, and the heat sink. And if you didn't know, the heat sink is basically going to act like an extended magazine. It's going to extend the time of firing before the weapon overheats. And with this particular weapon, it actually does increase it pretty far before it actually overheats. The heat sink is unlocked by getting 20 hip fires, and hip firing is another thing that's really poor with this weapon. It's not like you have a huge hip fire radius with the weapon, it's actually pretty tight. It's just the bullets fly in all different directions, so it's kind of difficult to do. The best thing that I found to do while going for my hip fire kills is laying prone and waiting for your prey. That's the best way that I can explain what I did. But I'm very thankful that it's only 20 hip fire kills for the heat sink, because all of those double kills they had to do with the heavy weapons and everything were just a pain in the ass, and the heat sink definitely helps, especially with this weapon, considering it's fully automatic. And that's just something to take into mind while going in and shooting all of the enemies you possibly can. Now, if you're a hardcore player, if you don't like playing core game modes and you want to use this, that's a good thing to say, because this is a great weapon at a range. I noticed even in core, while going for those long shot kills, it's still really easy to get headshots, it's still really easy to hit someone in the body, in the leg, in the foot, and still get like a cross map quick kill. In hardcore, that definitely shows, because the damage over range on this weapon is ridiculously awesome. You'll be able to get one shot kills from a very far distance. Talking more about long range kills, that's another thing that this weapon has, and it's a lot of recoil. You're gonna have to try to combat it some way, so putting on the foregrip is a great start. The foregrip, however, doesn't cut away all of the recoil on this weapon. It does, however, help you manage it, and that's one thing that I can be thankful for. So if you don't want to use three attachments on this weapon like I am in the gameplay, you can go ahead and just use two of them. My go-to attachments for this would be the heatsink, just so I have like extended fire time, and I would also go with the foregrip to help with the recoil. Another thing that I want to touch base on that's more of a benefit to this weapon than anything is you really don't have to waste an attachment spot for like a red dot sight or any other optic, because the iron sights are beautiful. That's what I'm using in this gameplay, actually. It almost has a shape of a red dot sight, and you really won't have to worry about it too much. The accuracy of the weapon overall, I mean, you know, given all of the recoil it has, it's still pretty good. You don't have to worry too much about using a red dot sight to hit your target, because basically wherever you put your iron sights, you're gonna be good to go, and that's with any weapon, but it's almost more accurate with the iron sights, I feel. Instead of using the red dot sight, I always went with the iron sights just because I felt like I was able to hit my mark a lot better. And I know that sounds weird, because I love using red dot sights on any of my assault rifles. And that's another thing that you have to think about. This is an assault rifle. It's not a submachine gun. You're still going to be weighed down by it, but not like heavy weapons. You're still going to be able to move pretty quickly around the map, but I always like using lightweight just to help me out. Toughness is also a nice thing to have when playing core game modes, but like I said, if you're playing hardcore, one shot kill city, baby. It is awesome. It's great to use in hardcore because that damage over range, it just doesn't seem like it's decreased at all. So all in all, is this weapon overpowered in any way, shape, or form? Honestly, I don't think so. With all of the downsides that this weapon has, all the recoil, the slow rate of fire, the overheating, it's something that is to be expected with a directed energy weapon, but that's another thing that you have to think about. All of the benefits you have with this weapon, infinity ammo, you never have to reload. As long as you manage your shots and you manage who you're killing, you'll be good to go. But that is another downside to it, the overheating. It can happen often, especially when you're not using the heat sink. It almost seems like you're able to shoot, I would say, 15 shots before it actually overheats. And if you're in an engagement with like two or more people, it's going to be very hard to take them all out without that thing overheating. So that's one attachment that I will definitely recommend to you guys to go for right off the bat. Go for the heat sink, 20 hip fire kills, and you're good to go. But anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you enjoyed the first look at the AE4 Widowmaker with royalty camouflage. If you did, make sure to leave a like down below. Do not forget to hit that subscribe button for more awesome videos each and every day. And until next time, I am out. Peace!